Download Tarang online radio app from Google Play Store.
And read, you will understand how an ordinary person can change himself into an extraordinary person. So today's my topic, see the time allotted for all of us is only 10 minutes. Is any speaker to speak voluminous on Mahatma Gandhi, it requires 2 hours, 3 hours, even one full day. So I'm not going to do that. I selected the topic which was given to me, health and fitness. Health and fitness in the Mahatma Gandhi's perspective. That is what I have chosen. So here I have just prepared a small, I've shortened it as a 10 points program. 10 tips of Gandhiji for keeping oneself fit and healthy. See, first of all, I would like to tell all of you, you keep your mind clean. Your mental problems, what happens is you have jealousy, vengeance, and lot of other things. You are just trying to put somebody down. All these ideas in your mind will stress you out. You will become unhealthy. The Gandhiji has said that. So 10 tips. So first I'll read, what is strength? See, Gandhiji says that the strength will come from your struggle. If you are struggling, you will understand the your strength which is there. This is a very nice quoting. Next. So these are the 10 points. So because of his, you know, Gandhiji, he went for studying in London. After his studies, he did Bharat Law. After becoming a barrister, he came back to Bombay, and from Bombay he was practicing lawyer, and he was selected by some Gujarat company to go to South Africa. And in the South Africa, what happened? He got into a first class train, and he was traveling in a first class train. The Britishers, so-called the whites, they did not like a brown fellow sitting there. They threw him out of the train. He showed his ticket. He shows that I am having a first class ticket. Even then they did not listen. The place name was Peter Mitzberg. It is the place. Today some function is also being held there. So the first is, if you want to keep healthy and fit, you should practice non-violence, ahimsa. He says that ahimsa is the greatest strength. That's how he threw out the Britishers. Next. The next is, go to bed early and get up early. If you want to be fit and healthy, you go to bed early, don't think about anything, and then next morning get up early. 7 to 8 hours of sleep is enough. Next. So next is, fasting promotes health. Many of us, he says that our stomach is not a dustbin. It should not be made as a dustbin for you. Keep on adding everything. Have a regular take of good food, healthy food, so that you don't take more. So he also says that at times going for fasting. So that's why by doing fasting, he did a lot of activities so that the Britishers were afraid of his fasting. So one, if you want to keep healthy, do fasting in a week, once or twice. Okay, next. Next is, watch your diet. What you should eat. Very, whatever healthy food. And he had become, even though he was a non-vegetarian family, he had become vegetarian. So vegetarianism is very good for health. That is what he recommends. Next. Next is walk. Walking, he used to do at least 10 kilometers of walk. See, because he had done this practice, this walking. Walking keeps fit. Even the doctors here, Dr. Chandran is sitting here, he can vouch that 30 minutes of walk for people like us, grown up, adults and all that, 25 minutes to 30 minutes of walk keeps your heart very good. But Gandhiji used to walk 10 kilometers. Practicing 10 kilometers, that's how it was made. That's why he made Dandi March, 390 kilometers. And that was a real successful story of Gandhiji. Next, that's how you can be fit. Then you can be fit by avoiding tobacco, alcohol. He has written a book. He has written a book when he was kept in the Aga Khan Palace during 1942 to 1944. He was kept in a house arrest. At that time, he has written a book called as Key to the Health. So in that he describes what is the best form of maintaining our own health. So like that, he says that I have picked up the tip, avoid alcohol and tobacco, which is the root cause of all problems. Next. Next is practice meditation. Now everybody knows meditation will make you very sound body and sound mind. So even from the ages, he says in his book, from the ages our people, all the sages had done it, and now this has become, the meditation has become a great stress reliever. Next. Think positive. Always don't try to think harming somebody. Think positive. Always thinking positive keeps you very healthy and fit. Next. Next is forgive. The forgiveness, if somebody is troubling you, you have to have the quality of the forgiveness gives you the strength. You will become a very strong person. So that is what you have to advocate. Next. So show compassion to others. So this also makes you fit, because you will not be thinking. Earlier I told that your mind, the mind which is working like a devil, how to spoil somebody else, how to disturb somebody, how to keep vengeance, all this will make a man. So that's why he says that show compassion to everybody, compassion to the animals, compassion to the fellow beings, compassion to everyone which you are mingling. So that will make you healthy and fit. So these are the 10 tips I have picked up from Gandhiji's perspective. I hope that you have clearly understood how a person should be healthy and fit. Thank you very much.
Our next speaker is Dr. P.S.M. Chandran, who is the president of the Indian Sports Medicine Federation, a very close associate of LNCP. So please.
A very good morning to all of you. Can I rush through my slides, because time is very precious. There is always a discussion on health and fitness. What is health and what is fitness? I would like to say that health and fitness is there two sides of the same coin. One, there are health parameters which are well defined. One can be healthy at the same camp, one need not be fit. Health is a general term. Everybody has to be healthy. For example, your BP, blood pressure, your pulse, heart, everything is normal, you are called healthy. But when it comes to fitness, fitness is a relative term. Fitness for what? You have to fit for a particular task given to you. You need not be fit for all tasks. What is your occupation depends on that, your task will remain same, will not be same. Next one. Yeah, the World Health Organization has defined health. I won't go into details. It's a complete state of well-being, mental, physical, physiological, and now they added social fitness also as a health parameter. Next one. The World Health Organization defines fitness as a capacity to carry out a muscular work. that's a fitness criteria. Next one. I can't see the slides properly. The distance is so much. The question comes wellness. Wellness is a total overall feeling which includes physical, mental, health, fitness, all included. Anyway, see the health parameters, if you don't suffer from certain diseases which are defined there, you can be called healthy. If you suffer from all these parameters, that means you cannot be healthy. Next one. Then your fitness criteria, your cardiovascular fitness, your muscular strength, muscular endurance, body composition, flexibility, all these elements constitute your criteria for fitness. Next. The walking, jogging, cycling, all these constitute aerobic exercises. Next. Your muscular strength and endurance. Next. Flexibility, if your body is flexible, you can escape from a lot of age-related health problems. For example, backache is the commonest age-related back problem. If your flexibility is good, you can escape from incidents of backache. Next. Body composition also, if you have got too much of fat, it is a health sign of unhealthiness. And fat can be reduced through exercise and diet. Next. Then skill-based fitness, speed, power, agility, flexibility, coordination, all these comes under skill-based, because if you are in a particular sport, you have to be having these developed, you have to develop these fitness criteria. Next. We talk a lot of introducing sports compulsory in schools, but you must remember that health and fitness comes first before sports. Next. Fitness, physical fitness, this particular slide, I make it important. Health is dealt by the health ministry. Sports is dealt by the sports ministry. Education is dealt by the education ministry. Then who deals with physical fitness in this country? No ministry is responsible to develop physical fitness of the general population. And that's a very unfortunate situation where the government has to make up its mind there. Next. Sports for all. When we think of sports for all, it should be fitness and health for all. And children has to need to be healthy and fit. Anybody who wants to do sports, they have to be healthy and fit. So when we try to introduce sports compulsory in schools, we have to ensure that the children who are to take up sports are healthy and fit to do the sports. And children, there's fitness programs for children varies from adults and elder people. Children can take up sports, fitness programs, these are, they have to develop flexibility, agility, all these elements in the early part of their life. Next one. I have shown the slide on skipping, trampoline and all. And everybody, if we can do skipping, I wonder how many of the national campers even keep a skipping room in their sports kit. Skipping is one of the commonest and easiest exercise to do, but one of the most neglected exercise is skipping. And all top athletes of the world, they carry a skipping rope they carry inside their sports kit bag, but I have hardly seen Indians doing that. Next. When it comes to health and fitness for the adults, it is the parameters varies. It has to be running, swimming, and weight training comes after the age of 14. Before that, no weight training should be recommended. Next, when it comes to senior citizen, brisk walk, jogging, swimming, all these constitute the exercise modalities for the elderly people. Next. See, the World Health Organization and International Federation of Sports Medicine, they have together conducted a lot of research in which they have found that our leisure habits, like not walking through the steps and using the lifts, all these sedentary activities enhances national wastage of manpower and effort. It has to be healthy, then you have to do exercises. Next. You have to concentrate on sports for all age groups, children, adolescent adults, and disabled sports. And one thing I am fond of is that juvenile homes, where you put the youngsters behind the bars, could be a good area to develop sports. Even prisons could be a good area to develop sports. Prisoners spend a lot of years behind the bars. They could be trained as good athletes. Next. Unfortunately, the infrastructure, manpower, spent by government departments, private sector, public sector, all these are found wanting. There are not much effort put into developing fitness. Concentration is mainly on health and sports, but fitness takes a back seat always. Next. But fitness can be developed through sports medicine, sports sciences. That is also an application. Now I found that Dr. Jayatilak is here and he is looking after sports. Being a doctor, I'm sure he can contribute a lot for Kerala in the field of sports medicine, sports sciences development. Thank you very much. Thanks.
That was Dr. P. S. M. Chandran, President, Indian Federation of Sports Medicine. Our next speaker will be Dr. Jose James, former registrar, Mahatma Gandhi University, and previously Director of Physical Education, Mahatma Gandhi University. He will speak on sports for peace and development.
My co-presenters, dignitaries, and my dear students. Well, originally my time was allotted about 10 minutes, but because of the paucity of time, I don't want to go into the details of the slide. Also, I don't want to go in detail about my presentation. The topic allotted to me is sports for peace and development. Of course, all of us know that from the very beginning, sports was used as a medium for peace as well as for development also. Even the Olympic motto, as we see in our Olympic motto, sports is used for the promotion of peace and development, has been at the core of the IOC's mission since its creation in 1894. Parent de Coubertin, the IOC's founder, was explicit in his desire to use Olympicism as a means for promote harmony among individuals and nations at all levels, from casual practice to competitive sports. So sports at all times, all over the world, at all ages, at all stages, was used as a platform for peace development. And we have seen so many examples in sports is used for peace. Not only in India, but all over the world. Even the greatest ping pong diplomacy, and even the latest, you know, that both the Korean teams marched in the Asian Games under one flag and one country. These are all unforgettable things, and as we consider sports for peace, as well as for the development area also. There are so many development indicators which we can proclaim in our development in pointers. But when considered sports as a medium for development of an individual, all these areas join into our individual as well as for the nation and as well as for the society also. So for sports is a medium for the development of sports as well. Sports is a medium for development of peace and development in any greater terms or in any greater evaluation procedures. For that only, United Nations is giving a lot of importance for sports, and United Nations has declared April 6th every year as the International Day for Sports for Development and Peace. So every year, the United Nations, with support of the member nations, celebrate the day called International Day for Sports for Development and Peace. India also is no exemption, and we also conduct International Day for Sports for Peace and Development in our country also. So this is an opportunity for all the sports and physical education people, especially those who are working in the field of sports and physical education, to celebrate this day and promote sports as a medium for peace and development in our country, for the younger generations to come in between, and all the young physical educators sitting here should take advantage of this idea and should come up and with these words, and because of the paucity of time, I conclude. Thank you very much.
And the last of the speakers, we have a very experienced person from the media, Sri Pranab Prakhar, Editor-in-Chief, Vision TV World, and he will speak on Hum Fit To India Fit. He has 22 years of experience in broadcasting and communication. He did a course at Harvard University on executive education program for senior executives, working professionals and leaders. He is an MBA from the London Metropolitan University. Please, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Sri Pranab Prakhar.
Thank you, everybody. First, let me thank guest of honor, Dr. Rajesh Kumarji, for gracing the occasion. Thank you, principal sir, and thank you to madam for giving me the opportunity to present ourselves. I've took this mic not because I'm a journalist, I took this mic because I want to interact with you, because there are a lot of students here and it is good to get some cheers from them. I would also like to, I missed the name, Dr. A.J. Jayathilak, IS Principal Secretary, Government of Sports and Youth Affairs, Government of Kerala. Thank you, sir. I missed your name. I apologize for that. Let's move forward in a very fast forward manner. This is what Prakhar Media is all about. We run Twitter, Vision Television World as a YouTube channel. You all can access that. First slide, please. This is what Gandhiji said, though we are, because we are running against time, we'll begin with this slide. Gandhiji said, cleanliness is next to goldliness. And my topic for today is, hum fit to India fit. And I assume aap log ko ye naam bahut zyada yaad hoga, hamare IMB minister, who is also the sports minister. Can we run that video, please? This video is interesting because I don't need a bigger brand ambassador to speak about my topic than...
Namaskar, दोस्तों, मैं जब भी प्रधानमंत्री जी को देखता हूं तो उनसे प्रेरित होता हूं। एक जबरदस्त ऊर्जा है, दिन रात काम करते हैं और वो चाहते हैं कि पूरा भारत फिट हो जाए। अब मैं उनसे प्रेरित होकर अपने काम में थोड़ा सा व्यायाम शामिल कर लेता हूं। आपके फिटनेस का मंत्र क्या है? एक वीडियो बनाइए, पिक्चर खींचिए और सोशल मीडिया पर डालिए ताकि पूरा देश प्रेरित हो जाए। आइए हम सब मिलकर एक फिट इंडिया बनाएं। हम फिट तो इंडिया फिट।
The energy that oozes out of the cradle of sports in India and certainly for athletics. I was amazed, really amazed. I have a message for this video. Because you are all students and you're all the future of India, you all represent India in the international stage. Why not you all create SAI video in under your LNCP at Thiruvananthapuram here? Because that will not only give you communication skills, not only give you visibility, but the world at large is awaiting to see you all. And there are so many medal winners here in Asian Games. So I think this video will always be, a video something like this will always be useful. Here are the gold medal winners. What I was trying to bring, that when Rajwardhan Rathore won the medal, I was reporting from his house for Doordarshan at that point of time, and there was only one silver, but that silver was a silver lining for Indian sports. And this is the list that goes on. In 12 we won many more medals, and in 16 we had our Nari Shakti back again at Rio de Janeiro. Moving to the next slide. This is what you all know, nothing more to add. But then this most important thing here to know is Kerala, at this place, at this venue, you created history by developing so many medal winners. And the credit goes to Principal Sir. Thanks, sir, for your great initiative and making it presence felt. Yeah, the students are. Now I know there are real champions in here. Going back to the next slide, please. Change, please. This is the quotation from Mahatma Gandhi. Lavatory must be clean as a drawing room. And I don't only quote Mahatma Gandhi here, I want to practice it. At our Vision Television Studio, Prakhar Media India Private Limited, the first thing I do in the morning is go and see the lavatories in my office and ensure that it is clean. If not, then I do it. I take the challenge to do it. And I wish we all should be motivated enough. Next, please. This is a video because I had a very big presentation, but then 2 days back, I happened to meet Union Minister of State for Health, Ashwini Chaubeji. And I put this question which is being raised here, comfort, India Aid, Swachhta, Ayushman Bharat. Here is the video that I did. I'll bring you excerpts from that video.
सर, आपने ये जो कहा कि 10,000 करोड़ की बचत हुई, सर इसका क्या आकलन कहाँ से है और क्या डेटा हो सर?
देखो, अमृत योजना जो सरकार ने चलाई है उसमें विशेष करके एमआरपी प्राइस जो है वो 30-40% कम है ये, और वो MRP प्राइस को घटाने के कारण, और पूरे उसके डाटा है, और हमने लगभग 200 के करीब अमृत योजना का दुकान हमने चलाई है बड़े बड़े संस्थाओं में, और उससे 10,000 करोड़ रुपए की बचत पिछले इस साल में हुई है, 10,000 करोड़। और विशेष करके जो कैंसर का बीमारी है या हार्ट का, ये इन सारी बीमारियों में आपको मैं ये कह सकता हूँ कि 30% से लेकर 60% और कुछ कुछ में तो 90% तक की छूट। अब ये आप सोच सकते हैं, ये दवाई जैसे जन औषधि होता है, भारतीय जन औषधि योजना 3,000 हमारी दुकानें, अब उसमें जन औषधि योजना में हम विभिन्न प्रकार के दवाइयों को दे रहे हैं, तो उससे 50% दवाइयों में बचत है। तो ऐसी बीमारी या दवा हो जो सस्ती हो, सुलभ हो, और हमारा जो हेल्थ केयर हमारा है, तो जब तक हम जैसे न्यूट्रिशन की बात आई है, तो न्यूट्रिशन में हम तो कहते हैं कि माँ का स्तनपान करना, माँ का दूध पीना, जो कहते हैं कि आप जिगर के टुकड़े हो, तो आज जिगर का दिन है, आज हृदय रोग का, आज सुबह सुबह मैं दौड़ के आया हूँ, बड़े रोज व्यायाम करता हूँ, लेकिन सुबह में आज स्वच्छता को लेकर के एक बड़ा अभियान हमारे मेडिकल कॉलेज के लोगों ने रखा था, तो आज हृदय का विशेष करके विश्व हृदय दिन, जिसको विश्व वर्ल्ड हार्ट डे है और उसको मनाते हैं, मैंने कहा जो अपने माँ का दूध पिया है, जितना दूध पिएगा उतना ही बच्चा न्यूट्रिशन उसको नहीं सारे, चूँकि बीमारी को जब क्षमता शरीर में कम होता है तो बीमारी जकड़ लेता है, और इसलिए माँ का दूध पीना ये अपने आप में न्यूट्रिशन के लिए सबसे बड़ा अगर कहा जाए तो।
दिस वीडियो बेसिकली टॉक्स अबाउट दैट health, fitness, swachhta, how it all could be brought together, and most important, how much government has saved, government of India has saved on by spending on the swachhta and the fitness part has improved a little bit. Next video. See, this is a small summary about what Mahatma Gandhi used to do in untouchability and insanitation. Mahatma Gandhi took this as an initiative and propagated to the world. Now, moving next. Yes, thank you very much. My only small message to you all students here, that go make your organization a big name for that. Be proud of the place, your teachers, your coaches. This is a cradle of sports in India. I have been working on journalism for quite some time, almost 2 decades now, at the most highest level. But I find this place as a homecoming for me. Thank you, Principal Sir, for giving me the opportunity and inviting me. I wish to make more videos, and surely we will be more be interested. Thank you very much for giving me the opportunity once again.
विजन टीवी देख रहे हैं इनका सबको, दर्शकों को मैं यही बोलना चाहता हूं कि आगे जो आने वाले हमारे कंपटीशन है, मेरे लिए कीजिए प्रेयर कीजिए, क्योंकि जो आगे वाले काफ़ी हार्ड कंपटीशन टफ है, तो सभी मेरे लिए प्रेयर कीजिए कि आगे वाले कंपटीशन है उसमें अच्छा करूं मैं। विजन टीवी को बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद। विजन टीवी जिन्हें भी लोग देख रहे हैं इन्हें सारे मैं बहुत दिलों मतलब धन्यवाद करना चाहूँगा। मेरे लिए करो दुआ करो कि अगे जो आने वाले कॉम्पीटिशन है इसे काफ़ी करिए वधिया करिए, अगर वर्ल्ड चैंपियनशिप है मैं उम्मीद करता कि वो मैं बेस्ट ऑफ 6 आऊँगा, तो सभी मेरे लिए करना दुआ करना। थैंक यू विजन टीवी।